Good morning, good evening, good afternoon, whatever it is, wherever you are. My name is Andrew Grusset and welcome to another edition of Rise and Grind. Right, today's subject, we're talking about true passions here. We're talking about true passions and the following through on those passions. Now, before I get into this, I'm not necessarily talking about turning your passions into profits. I'm not necessarily talking about you going out there and you making a killing and making a million from following something that you're passionate about. What I'm talking about doing is following the thing that you're passionate about. What I'm talking about doing is including the passions that you have in your life. Yeah, so before we get into that, let's not get caught up into thinking that this is me going on about how you can make it rich and make it big. This is just about you. It's just about you doing the things that make you smile. It's just about you making sure that you include the things that make you smile. It's about making sure that you incorporate into your life things that make your life worth living. All so often I hear stories time and time and time again, and I remember going over them for myself and still get caught in them some myself of, you know, of working to pay bills, of existing. You know, I'd love to do this but I can't afford it. I'd love to do this but I can't find the time. I'd really like to take part in this pastime but it's impossible with my schedule, with my family demands, with my work demands, with my just demands. It's impossible. I can't get to do this thing that I really, really want to do because I can't find the time, because I have to spend the time working to earn the money to pay the bills. I put it on an AG Inspires little post a few weeks ago now. Your bills will still be there. You know, most of these companies that you owe money to, they put these scary letters and send out, but at the end of the day, they'll still be there. But your life is worth something, and it's worth more than you just sitting down there in a mundane job from Monday to Friday, from 9 to 5, just to tick the box on the thing and send a back transfer over to some company in the back end or beyond that doesn't know you. This is your life that we're talking about here. Your life. This is you doing something that means something to you whilst you're still capable of doing it. All around you and all around the world, there are people faced with news or situations which mean that in a few months' time, in some cases, they're not going to be here. Let that sink into your equilibrium up here. There are people receiving news right now that are saying, you know what? Brace yourself, because you ain't going to be here for too much longer. There are families getting to grips with the fact that they're not going to have a son, a daughter, a mother, a father here for very long. And here's the trick. When that day comes, you see what these big companies have been sending you all these scary letters about. You know what they do? They hit the flipping delete button and that thing goes away because the person's gone away. But that person spent all of their life fretting about receiving those letters and satisfying those needs. We'll have to do another video a little later on, probably not in this series, probably in the next one, about managing your finances and managing yourself around your bills. But please take note from this one here. You need to follow your passions. That's where your smiles come from. You need to follow the things that make you feel good. Because that's where the laughter comes from. You need to do you at some point in time. So my challenge to you is this. Pick three things that you would like to do. Now bear in mind I said not three things that you like. Three things that you would like to do. So these are new experiences. New things to go and take up. Maybe a new hobby. New place to go and visit. A new activity to go do. Maybe you want to go and learn, play a violin, saxophone. Maybe you want to go and sing out in public because you're secretly a Diana Ross in your bathroom. Whatever it is, three things. Pick three things that you would like to do. And over the course of the next 3 months, find a way to do one a month. This is not an overbearing task. One thing a month. One new experience a month. Bag it. Bag a story around it. Experience it. Live it. Your life was given to you for you to live. The talents that you were given for you to push forward with and make happen and bring the world a happier place, to bring a new substance to life, to bring smiles and happiness to somebody else. I don't know what your passion is. Maybe your passion is that you want to get into acting. Maybe your passion is that you want to go and sing. If you want to go and get into acting, then fine. Go take an acting class. There are plenty of free ones at various different colleges around London, around the UK, around the world. You know, if it's that you want to sing, it doesn't have to be a massive stage. Go find yourself a karaoke, grab a mic, sing a song. Whatever it is it may be, whatever your passion is in life, find a way to make it happen, because there is always a way within your situation right now. You just have to be brave enough to go embrace it and brave enough to go make it happen. So go do that for you. Go do that for yourself. You never know. The answer to that thing that is making you frown may only come to light, after you have found a smile. I used to sit there for hours upon hours looking at spreadsheets that didn't add up, making myself go absolutely crazy, crying myself to sleep because I couldn't get this thing to add up, couldn't get this thing to move forward. It became this big dark cloud, encompassed everything and blocked out the light everywhere. And you know, it wasn't until I was forced by those around me to take a day out. To take a day out, go do something. And I didn't do anything, ironically. I went and kind of sat in a favorite pub of mine in Greenwich and watched the day slide away. But it filled me with so much joy to not be worried. It filled me with so much joy to not be scared, to not have fear follow me. That, you know what, when I came back to work the following day, that answer went straight into my head. The minute I flipped the computer screen on, I knew exactly how to handle it. Sometimes a break is required to force your system to reset and rest, to be able to come back and let you know what you need to do next. So if you're one of those, if you're sat there at the moment confused and don't understand how or what you're supposed to do or where you're supposed to go next, trust me on this one. You probably already know the answer, but don't have the clarity enough to see. Stop committing spiritual suicide. Follow your passions and dreams. Let them loose, let them out, let them live free. And put money, as promise you, that through that action, you'll spark something in your soul. It's quite amazing. That's me out for this week. Thank you very much for watching. Again, can't stress it enough. Keep your letters, keep your emails, keep your comments flowing. We're creating a bit of a stockpile now for the Out of Sag shows. If you sent yours in already, then please bear with me. Patience, I will get to each and every one of them, even if I have to extend it out to 2 broadcasts a week. For everyone, if you want to send in comments or suggestions for things to cover in the Rising Grind series, and please feel free to send them through. Again, just bear with me, we'll schedule them, we'll get round to them, and we'll tag everybody up, we'll tag you up in the comment section of it when we put it out to say thanks. Again, please feel free to like, comment, share and subscribe to the channel. And as usual, until next week, stay strong, stay focused. They said.